Hello, event organizers and venue managers. In this video, I want to show you how easily you can create a venue and an amphitheater-style seating chart. I intentionally picked a pretty complex seating chart with about 500 seats to demonstrate all the powerful features, and as you will see, we are going to build the seating chart in a few minutes. So here is the seating chart. It is scanned from a paper seating chart. Looking at the seating chart, here is the stage, and there are six sections. The seating chart is designed with the stage at the top. It is recommended that we design the chart when the stage is at the bottom. When we are done with the design, we can optionally rotate the seating chart to have the stage back at the top. So, I'm going to rotate this picture so the stage is at the bottom. Let's take a closer look at the seating chart. There is a balcony right section starting from row A to I, and each section has seven seats. The seats start from left to right, from 7 to 1, in descending order. Looking at orchestra right section, it also has seven seats, but they're from 1 to 7, in ascending order. Looks like the seating chart is not very consistent, and it adds to the complexity. However, we can simply design it. Looking at the balcony center, it is the most complex section. The seats start from 1 to 15 in ascending order, except for the last row. Row I, that starts from seat 5 to 15, and also the two front rows are missing some seats in the middle of the row that is probably reserved for recording and audio equipment. Row A starts from seat 1 to 7. Then some open space, and then seats 8 and 9. Interestingly, row B is not consistent with row A. Row B also starts from 1 to 7 and some blank space, but this time seats 14 and 15 instead of 8 and 9. This is an interesting seating chart to work on. Looking at the orchestra center section, you can see that each row has a different number of seats and they are visually aligned in the center. So let's get started. I'm going to the Control Panel, Events and Venues panel, then Venues button, and create a new test. Seating chart name is optional, so I'm leaving it empty. Set the region to your venue's address. The most important field here is the time zone, because all the events times, including event date and time, sales start date, and sales end date are calculated based on the venue's time zone. So, let's set it and save the venue. The venue should show up here in the list of the venues. I can edit it, and then I can open the seating chart designer from here. This is the seating chart designer page. The related walkthrough for designing a seating chart opens up here. I highly recommend that you go through the walkthrough steps. For this video, I'm just going to skip and close it. This is the seating chart designer area. The designer area is expandable from right and bottom, so you can add as many sections or objects as needed. But it doesn't expand from the left or top. So it is important to start from the top left section to make sure that you don't run out of space. I'm going to start with the balcony right section, and then expand to the right and to the bottom. Click here in the seating chart designer area. Click on Add Section, name it Balcony Right. So what is the sales priority? When the buyer asks to be assigned the best available seat, the system uses the section priority to determine which section is a better section or has the best view of the stage. In this seating chart, it looks like the orchestra center is the best section and has the best view. Orchestra right and orchestra left are the second best sections. The balcony center is probably the next best, and then the balcony right and balcony left are last in terms of priority. We are going to set the sales priority accordingly and relative to each other. So I'm going to assign one or best section to orchestra center. I will assign two to orchestra left and right as the Y have same priority. We'll assign three to balcony center and four to balcony right and left. So for this section, sales priority is going to be four. setting the visual alignment of the rows in the section. All the rows in section have equal number of seats, so the alignment technically doesn't make any sense, and they're going to be aligned perfectly from left and right. Setting the order of the sales. The best seats in this section are the seats to the right, and they are closer to the stage. For example, seat number 1 and 2 are better than 7 or 6. So we want to start selling from right to left. I'm going to set the sales preference from right to left. Save the section. The section is created here. So now I'm going to add rows to it. I should start from the row in the front, row A, and continue to row I. Seats start from 7 to 1, so the seats are in descending order from left to right. I'm going to select the descending order. Row name is A, and seat number from 1 to 7. Setting the direction and order of seats can be a little bit confusing, so after adding the first row, I'm going to hover the mouse over the seats in this row to make sure they are created in the order I expect. I'm going to verify that seat A7 is to the left and seat A1 is to the right. Now with the same setting, I'm going to add the rest of rows, row B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I. So this section is all done. Row I is at the top, farthest from the stage, and row A is at the front, and each row has seats from seat 1 to 7. I can verify that the capacity is 63 seats. So let's continue to the next section, Balcony Center. I'm going to click here inside the orange box to add the section. The priority of this section is 3, because it's a little bit better than Balcony Left and Right, which had the priority of 4. I am setting the name to Balcony Center. For the visual alignment, all the seats are aligned from left to right, except the very last row, which is missing seats 1 through 4, and the row is aligned to the right. So, I'm going to set the section alignment to the right alignment. For the sales preference, since it is a center section, it really doesn't matter if you start selling from left to right or right to left, because seat 1 is as good as seat 15. I selected left to right to start selling from seat 1. I'm going to drag this section to align it with the other section, and I'm going to click on Add Row Link. For this section, the seats from left to right are numbered 1 to 15 in ascending order. So I select ascending order. The first row in the section, row A, starts from seat 1 to 9. I'm going to put A here, from 1 through 9. Add row. Let's double check to make sure A1 is to the left and A9 is all the way to the right. Let's not worry about the space in between for now. Then row B is from 1 to 15. And it is the same for rows C, D, E, F, G, H. Row I is from 5 to 15. Now that we created all rows, let's take care of the empty space in row 1. Row A basically has 9 seats, and there is some space to the right of seat 7. So I'm going to click on seat 7. I'm going to add some space to the right of seat 7. I'm going to set it to 85. So I'm going to click on seat 7. I'm going to add some space to the right of seat 7. I'm going to set it to 85 to make it align with the other rows. You can find this number with some try and error. For example, if I put 100, the seats are not going to be aligned. So row A is now looking as expected. Seats 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, some space, and then 8 and 9. Now let's move on to row B. Row B is a little bit different. The seats are from 1 to 15, but seats 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13 are missing. So I'm going to click on seat 8 and mark it as this seat is not available. Hide it. It hides the seat and moves the seats to the right. I'm going to repeat the same step for seat 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Let's say you mistakenly hide seat 14 as well. I'll show you how to bring back that seat. So hide seat 14. And then I notice, seat 14 should be back, but it's not there anymore. So I can click on any other seat in the row, and I see a list of all the hidden seats in the row at the bottom. Just click on seat 14 to bring it back. Looking at row B, now I can see seats 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14, and 15. I'm going to click on seat 7, and I'm going to add 85 pixel space to the right, so the row gets aligned with other rows in the section. The section, which is different from the other rows, and the row is aligned to the right as expected. Let's proceed to the next section. Add another section. The priority is 4. The name is Balcony Left. The alignment of the seats doesn't matter because all the rows have the same number of seats, but the sales priority from left to right because the left seats are better seats and should be sold first. Save it. Align it. Add row. So the rows are from left to right in ascending order, as they are all from 1 to 7. Rows are from A to I, so I'm going to put A here. 1, 7, add row, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I. Let's proceed to orchestra right section. I noticed that orchestra right section is very similar to the balcony left. They both have 7 seats that are ordered from left to right in ascending order, numbered 1 through 7. The only difference is this section has fewer rows, and it only has row A through F. So instead of creating a new section, I can duplicate the balcony left section and apply the changes. I click on the gear icon for the balcony left section and click on Duplicate Section. It creates a duplicate of this section. I drag it here. Then I click on the gear icon and edit the section. I change the name to Orchestra Right. And the sales priority to 2, then save it. Now I have to delete all the extra rows from row G to I. I click on the empty space in the row to open the Edit Row pop-up. It is important to click on the empty space in the row and not any seat. Otherwise, it will open the Seat Editor pop-up. Then click here to delete the row, close the pop-up, and repeat for rows H and I. Now my section has only row A, B, C, D, E, and F. let's proceed to the orchestra center section. It doesn't look like any other sections, so I cannot use replication. Click inside the orange box and add the section. The sales priority is 1, as it is the best section. The name is Orchestra Center. The visual alignment of the rows is centered. The sales order can be left to right or right to left, as it is the center section. I set it to left to right, so it starts selling from seat 1. I'm going to add the rows. It is important to add the rows from the very bottom row, or the row closest to the stage, row A. Row A has seats from 1 to 9, and it is in ascending order. Let's add row A. Row B has 1 extra seat. From seat 1 to 10, and it is aligned center to row A. C has 11 seats, and each row adds 1 seat. And D goes up to 12. E goes up to 13. And F goes up to 14. And G goes up to 15. Let's continue to the last section, Orchestra Left. This section is very similar to Orchestra Right, except that it's missing row F. So I'm going to do Duplicate Orchestra Right. Move it all the way here. Edit the section. Set the name to Orchestra Left. The sales priority is again 2, alignment right. But the sales preference is from left to right, and I save the changes. I'm going to click on an empty space in row F to delete the row. It's important not to click on the seats because when you click on the seat, it opens the pop-up to edit the seat and not the row. Now I just delete this row. I noticed that the 3 orchestra sections have all different number of rows, but the front row, row A, must be aligned for the 3 sections. So I'm going to drag it a little bit down and drag this one a little bit down to align them. Now let's add the stage. Click here and click on Add Stage or Shape. I'm going to name it Stage and use a rectangular shape for it. Save it. Now I can drag it a little bit around and make it a little bit bigger. My seating chart is all ready. I'm going to zoom it in a little bit so it takes the whole width of the screen and looks better. All the changes we made are automatically saved, and there's no need to manually save the seating chart. The venue and the seating chart are all ready, and I can use them in as many events. The next step is to create an assigned seat event that uses this venue, and as part of the event creation, I will assign tickets to each seat on the seating chart. Technically, each seat, row, or section can have a different price level, and also each seat may have multiple price variations, meaning that a single seat may have a price for adults, kids, or seniors.